welcome to the online class. So in the previous class we have learned about the Guptas. So and also we have learned about the famous poet Kalidasa and his play that is Meghaduta and also Abhinanda Shakuntala. And also we have studied about the important scientists of Guptas period. So today's class let us go on to the next topic that is about the Vardhanas and also about the Nalanda. So in detail having a descriptive note and some important images regarding this session.
Now let us have a look on the Vardhanas. The Gupta Empire, which had flourished for two centuries, disintegrated around 6th century CE. Many small kingdoms sprung up at this time. The kingdom of the Vardhanas was one of them. They ruled from Thaneshwar in 6th century. Some copper inscriptions, Bana's Harshacharita and the Chinese traveler Huinzhang's writings throw light upon this period. Pushyabhuti is the founder of this dynasty. Prabhakaravardhana and Harshavardhana are the prominent kings of this dynasty. After the death of his father Prabhakaravardhana and his brother Rajavardhana, Harsha became the king of Thaneshwar. His sister Rajashri was married to the king of Kannauj. When the king of Bengal Shashanka killed the king of Kannauj, Harsha captured Kannauj and attacked the king of Bengal. Bengal and Magadha came under his rule, but he could not advance beyond the Narmada river in the south. The Kannada king of the Chalukyas, Pulakeshi II, halted his progress and forced him to go back. This achievement of Pulakeshi II has been immortalized in the panegyric Prashasti written by the court poet Ravikirti. He has expressed that the exultation of the king Harsha's joy had dried up on account of this defeat. The king's rule was assisted by the council of ministers. The bureaucracy consisted of the Mahasandhi Vigraha, the negotiator Mahabaladikruta, military general, Bhogapati, that is tax official, and Duta. The kingdom had been divided into provinces. Land tax was major source of income for the kingdom. Feudatory chiefs paid tribute to the king. The king gave them land grants and in return got the help of their armies. When the king became weak, the feudatory chiefs became independent. Land grants were given to other communities and religious people as well. Harsha gave prominence to Buddhism. We get details of the popularity of Buddhism from Huinzhang's writing. The Buddhist Nalanda University was full of activity during this period. It enjoyed a royal patronage. Let us have a look on Nalanda. Buddha's followers believe that Nalanda was the name of Buddha in his previous birth. This is famous as an ancient university. Buddha had visited Nalanda. Mention has been made of the 25-meter tall bronze image of Buddha that Harshavardhana gifted to Nalanda. Kumaragupta had made contributions to a fine arts school here. Nagarjuna, the chief exponent of middle path, Dinaga and Dharmapala were the other famous scholars who taught here. The Chinese traveler Huinzhang visited this place and stayed for some time. He has given a detailed inscription or description of this place. There were stupas, chaityalayas, viharas, rest houses, steps here and there to sit and rest a while. Meditation rooms, lecture rooms and many other structures reveal the glory of this place. The Gupta kings and Harshavardhana have been the famous patrons of this age. An accidental fire destroyed many texts at Nalanda. So dear children, we have studied about the Vardhanas, about Pushyabhuti, and also about the king of Bengal, Shashanka, who killed the king of Kanauj. Harsha captured the Kanauj and attacked the king of Bengal. So, and also about Pulakeshi II, about the Nalanda and all. So, thank you for watching this video.